How you doing? Scotty Bear back with another video. This video is about living in Tijuana and crossing the border into San Diego and working in the States. And if you're considering doing this, I have some very good information for you. And it really boils down to this time. And seeing how you're just about to have a lot of time on your hands, you need to think about this very carefully, because the amount of time that you commute across the border will really diminish your ability to do very much. I took a sample of many of the times I crossed, and I figured it took about 3 hours of my time. That's crossing over and then crossing back, commuting, buses, transportation, taxi libres, getting to the trolley, over to my destination. Because really, that's what it amounts to, is from the time you leave your door to the time that you were on your way to your destination on the U.S. side, and then returning home, crossing back into Mexico, which in most cases is mostly free and clear. Unless you drive across, then I think you even add more time. But if you're considering doing this, I highly recommend walking. Walking, I feel like you get the best chances to cross the border without a wait. I do think the line, I've had some very interesting situations happen to me in a car where they close lines and the line turns into complete chaos, which is very uncomfortable. You have to be very aggressive in holding your position. The line has really never failed me walking. However, I have crossed at some days that were just not worth my time, frankly. Now, the one thing about me personally, which provided me maybe a longer period in Tijuana, was I really didn't have to cross at any point. I did cross, I don't know the exact frequency, maybe once a week in general, maybe just for shopping and stuff, because really, the stuff in the United States is cheaper. You'll see if you cross any amount of time. People are commuting back and forth to get groceries and so on. So the commute is constantly going around the clock on the line. Now, it definitely gives you some advantage if you're able to find a job that has some off hours. You're going to get more show up and the ability to cross with minimal wait times. I definitely took advantage of this. Like, for instance, if you're a bartender and you work at night, you could probably cross after 3 o'clock many times with very little wait time. Then again, I will say that even with the surge of even more people moving to Tijuana, that that time has even increased further. So, I mean, you work 8 hours, or maybe beyond that, 9 or 10 hours, you can tack on 12 hours, 13 hours of your day is completely gone to working. I do think that Tijuana provides some nice savings, but I don't know if the time really equals the time you wait on the line and the everything you deal with. It really is quite an experience. I got to the point where I was a bit of anxiety. Oh, do I want to take a car? Boom. Do I want to walk? About the line, checking the line for time crossings and whatnot. Actually, I might, you know, not cross that day and wait for a better day to cross many times, because just trying to avoid waiting. And I would say my experience was mostly good. There was only about a handful of times that were really crazy that I was not willing to wait. And most of those times were around Christmas time. Anyway, if you are considering do this, good luck. I definitely understand, and have a good day.